My name is Michael Vetter. I live in Meco, Florida, and I build custom cars for a living. I like to build unique concepts that haven't been on the streets before. I like to do the higher upper end of fiberglass work. I can build pretty much anything from a picture to a completely finished product that's street legal. This particular car I call the extraterrestrial vehicle. I've been driving this car for the last 4 years, having a lot of fun with it. One of the reasons for this car was I had a little girl who's 6 years old now and has back seats, so I'm able to drive around with a sports car that still has family opportunities. So it starts off as a chunk of styrofoam. I shape the foam, make a hard mold off of the foam, then I make a body shell out of the molds, and then I build a drivetrain underneath that. So I've built this car with 5 different types of drivetrains. I've sent some overseas, like the Middle East, where they like Toyota drivetrains. This particular car is powered by a Chevrolet drivetrain, a 2-liter supercharged Chevy engine, transmission and air conditioning system. Custom-built suspension, so it's air adjustable, it goes up and down, so it doesn't have any problem with speed bumps. Like, a lot of people are like, how did that thing get here? I've done the same car with Porsche drivetrain and 100% electric. So it really depends on what a customer may like. This is the 8th one of these, so there are 7 running around, most of them overseas. We have one in the London Motor Museum. We have 2 of them in Dubai, one in Germany, one in Canada. There's one in Miami, another one in New Jersey. I think that's all of them. To build one of these, they run right around $100,000, depending on the drivetrain. All electric. If they really want to get a crazy drivetrain, the price can get upwards of $200,000, depending on how much of the chassis we have to custom build. I like to use a donor car. I could build this car on a Prius or a Nissan Leaf, and that would reduce the price a little. If they want V8, super, lots of power, you know, then they're of course much more expensive. And then I do have laminated DOT glass. You know, all the parts do have to be street legal parts that, you know, would be found on a normal car. It feels that the faster you go, it seems to get quieter inside. Through talking with people who do know about drag coefficient, I realized that the rear end being rounded actually creates a suction, so it's probably not as good as it could be. But I do this more for the aesthetics. You know, I like the looks of something different. This interior is all suede and leather with a bunch of brushed aluminum accents, and we have a machine shop making us nice aluminum parts, so just something to make it different. There's a front and rear camera on this car. I like to have a camera down low to the curb. I can pull within 2 inches of a curb and not tear up the front bumper. Rear camera because there's not a rear window. We are using a little 3D printing. We are just starting. This car was done by hand, and generally the first shape would cost me about $30,000 to $35,000 to make a styrofoam product into something we could make a mold of. Nowadays, the computer modeling, we're able to do that for about half the price, whereas 3 years ago it was about $100,000, today $15,000. So now we're able to put out a much better product and a lot faster. A lot of advantages to the 3D printing, 3D modeling, and it keeps the cost down because of time savings, and it makes the finished product even better because it's 100% symmetrical, which is very hard to do when you make a car from hand. I love to build custom cars, and I can build anything from a picture to a finished product. That's what I do. We have a large shop in Meco, East Coast of Florida, Central East Coast.